So Coach Danny Jacobs, one of the best pop-up fighters, him and Canelo, do you like the fight?
I love the fight. I hope the fight takes place. We'll see what happens. Everything is step by step, so we'll see what goes on.
If it's not Canelo, who's next for Danny?
I don't know. That's up to his promoter, Eddie Hearn, and of course, his manager and myself and Danny will sit down and we'll discuss what's best and go from there.
What do you think about Tank versus Loma?
I'd love to see the fight. I don't know if we'll see the fight. I very truly doubt if we'll see the fight, but it'd be a great fight.
Okay, Canelo Rocky Fielding, your prediction?
No disrespect to Fielding, but Canelo by landslide.
And then what does Canelo do next? Does he say 68? Does he go down to 60?
You know, that's a good question. We have to see how he feels when he goes in the ring on Saturday. If he feels good at 168, he might just stay there. I mean, he's done what he had to do. He's just winning, and it wouldn't be any shame to the game. He would be moving up into a bigger division with bigger guys, so that's a more daunting task. So we'll see what happens.
Who are you coaching these days?
Okay, our roster consists of Saddam Ali.
Who's also fighting on the card, Mauricio Herrera, of course.
Toriano Johnson. Curtis Stevens. Richard Comey.
Comey?
Richard Hickson.
Is he champion now, or is he fighting for the belt?
He's the IBF number one mandatory.
So who is he going to fight? Is he going to fight Lomachenko? He's 35, right?
At 35. He's fighting a young man, Garage, I think it's Garage. I can't even pronounce the name.
He takes your business. Comey's a monster. He's very talented.
Right.
Would you like to see him and Loma fight?
I would love to see
him
fight.
What happens in that fight?
You have a very exciting fight. You have to realize that Richard is a very, very powerful young man. He's tall. He has incredible reach. And he's tenacious.
We're losing. Unless you're waiting for Saddam.
No, I'm waiting for Saddam.
Okay.
It's a very interesting and exciting fight, and I have to say, with the way that Richie is coming along, it would be a very, very favorable fight for Richie.
Who's the pound for pound king of boxing right now?
Canelo Alvarez.
Why?
He brings the excitement factor. He brings the attraction, and if we are talking about talent, I'd have to say Terrence Crawford. But when we're talking about overall culpability of effects, it has to be Canelo.
Wilder Joshua, who wins?
Joshua.
Joshua Fury, who wins?
I'm going to have to sort of slide with Fury right now because I expect him to get better. And from his last performance, if he doesn't get knocked down, it's a washout.
Fury, Wilder, too.
I think Fury might pull it.
I think Wilder figured him out, and round 8 dropped him. It was a 9, and then round 12 dropped him.
Yeah, but I think those mistakes won't happen this time.
Let's see what happens.
I think so.
So, Andy, let's talk about having gear. You have gear. It's very good. If fighters want to order stuff, whether it's belts, cups, what else do you guys do?
Well,
outfits.
Havoc is totally apparel. And Havoc Athletics, which is actually the new namesake, is all sports all the time.
Okay.
So we're going to be venturing into all genres of sports.
Smart.
I'm working on a new website. When the information comes, I'll make sure you guys are the first to know. And as always, Havoc is in the house.
There you have one of the best coaches in the world. FaceTheDrewPoint.com, Racing Back Reporting.
Thank you.